companions had to flee twice to Abyssinia, migrations, hijra. Now, and they killed his daughter. What would they did to him and his people? Now, eventually he conquers his enemies. What does he do? He calls them. He said, what do you expect at my hands today? What do you expect now? They knew his nature too well. They said, mercy, O generous brother and nephew. So the Prophet of Islam, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, I will speak to you as Joseph spoke unto his brother, Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salam. You know what the brothers did to him? He said, I will speak to you as Joseph spoke unto his brother. He says, I will not scold you today. Go, ye are free. Time and place for forgiveness. Muhammad shows you when to forgive, that your enemy is under your control, you can do what you like with them, and then you say, look, I forgive you. Forgiveness. Fulfillment of prophecy. Jesus Christ and Muhammad are the closest in history to one another. And Jesus Christ is made to say, I referred to you about the Gospel of Saint John. Now, in the Holy Quran, in Surah Saf, you find that under S, Saf, chapter 61, verse 6. Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, Jesus Christ is made to say, وَإِذْ قَالَ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمَا, behold, Jesus, the son of Mary, said, يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ, O children of Israel, إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ, most certainly, I am the messenger of God sent to you all, you Jews. Rasulullah ilaykum musaddiqan lima bayna yadayya min at-tawrati, confirming the revelation which came before me in the Torah. Wa mubashiran bi rasulin ya'ti min ba'di ismihi Ahmad, and giving glad tidings of a messenger to come after me whose name shall be Ahmad, which is another name for Muhammad. He prophesied about the coming of our holy prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and this prophecy is still there in the Christian Bible. It is still there, despite the fact that his words are not preserved as a whole, despite the fact only 10% of the New Testament are the words of Jesus, according to what they have, what they say, what they claim. 90% is nothing to do with, is not the words of Jesus. 90%. Still, this prophecy is still there. Where? I was showing it to an Egyptian lady. See, I was in March, I was in Egypt. I had some visa problem. I won't go into details. A man from the Al-Azhar, he failed. So he brings an Egyptian lady, well attired, westernized lady, well spoken. And he says, this lady will help you. So she tried and she failed. So she tells me, look, sit for half an hour and I will try and see what I can do for you. She returns after over an hour and says, I want $40. I said, look, I'm a guest of the government. He said, look, $40, 20 for you, 20 for your son. I give her the $40. She was so well spoken, so I'm asking her, Ma ismuki, what little I know, a few words about Arabic. I said, Ma ismuki, what is your name? So she gave me a name. I can't remember, because it was so strange to me. Now, I never heard a name like that in my life. It went through one side, came out the other side. My second question. I said, Anta Muslima? Are you Muslim? She says, no, I'm a Christian. So I said, right. To me, she's my customer. Look, this is what the Muslim ought to be doing, looking for customers. Every Muslim. You know one fact? Look for a customer, for that one fact. Our Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Holy Prophet Muhammad, he said, Balighani walau aya. Deliver the message regarding me, even if it is one verse. If you know one fact, give it, man, give it. And Allah will give you more. This is the secret of knowledge. If you have one, you give. That one, you keep on giving. And Allah adds another and another. And your knowledge explodes, expands. This is the secret of learning. Give, man, give. So I said, now here's an opportunity. I said, you know, knowing now she's a Christian and she's an Egyptian. So I said, you know, Jesus, before he parted, he said, لَكِنِّي أَكُولُ لَكُمُ الْحَقُّ إِنَّهُ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِنْ أَنْتَلِكَ لِأَلَّهُ إِلَّا مَنْ تَلِكَ لَا يَعْتِيكُمُ الْمُؤَزِّ وَلَكِنْ إِنْ زَهَبْتُ أُرْسِلْهُ إِلَيْكُمْ. I didn't translate it for her, because she understood what I said. For your benefit, what I said was, I quoted her from the Gospel of St. John, chapter 16, verse 7, where it says, nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, the Comforter will not come unto you. But if I go, I will send him. That's what I quoted her in Arabic. So I'm asking her, who is this Mu'azzi? La yatikum al-Mu'azzi. So she says, I don't know. So I'm telling her, I said, you see, in the Quran we are told that Jesus said to his disciples, wa mubashiran bi rasulin yati min ba'di ismihi Ahmad, and giving glad tidings of a messenger to come after me whose name shall be Ahmad, which is another name for Muhammad, and Muhammad is Mu'azzi. She says, very funny. She says, you know these Egyptians, meaning the Muslim Egyptians, did they take us to the cinema? Did they take us to the dance? But nobody tells us about Mu'azzi. She gave me a sledgehammer to beat the Muslims with. Look, she says, these Egyptians, means your Muslim brothers, they take us to the cinema, this Christian woman, you take them to the cinema, you take them to the dance. And you know, from there where you go. But nobody tells us about Mu'azzi. So now as soon as I get into the city, I meet this elite Egyptian brothers of ours. And I'm telling them, I said, look, I met an Egyptian woman just now. Meticulous person, very well educated, and this is what she tells me, that you take them to the cinema, you take them to the dance, but you don't tell them anything about Mu'azzi. Is it true? And they say yes. Our brethren say yes. Ask another group. I say, is it true? He said yes. Everyone you ask, is it true what she says? He said yes. So what's wrong with you? 1,400 years you are there, the Muslim in Egypt is ruling, he's the master. For a few years the British were there, they were masters. For a few years the French were there, but overall for 1400 years the Muslim is master of Egypt. Overall, 1400 years, and in 1400 years you have not made even a scratch on the Christian community. I want to know why. Even now, are you prepared to talk to them? No. Utterly helpless. 40 million Muslims in Egypt, they're utterly helpless, speechless. They can't talk to the Christians. They can't. I want to know why. I'm asking them. I say, you Muslims, I said, you read the Quran in your own mother tongue. He said, yes. I said, you understand what you read? He said, yes. I said, look, my people, you, whether Pakistani, Bangladeshi, Hindi, my people, the non-Arab, all my people. I said, you see, my people, they read the Quran, but they don't understand what they read. But you understand what you are reading? He said, yes. So I said, Allah is telling you. He's telling us all, but because we don't understand, for us it's a water on duck's back. But as he's telling you, you Egyptians, Ya Ahlal Kitab, O people of the book, La Taghlu Fi Deenikum. O people of the book, meaning O Jews and Christians, La Taghlu Fi Deenikum. Say, do not go to extremes in your religion. Wa La Taqulu Ala Allah Illa Al-Haq. And don't say anything about Allah except the truth. Innamal Masih, most certainly the Messiah, translated Christ. Innamal Masih, Isa ibn Maryama, Jesus the son of Mary, Rasulullah, is a messenger of Allah. Wa kalimatuhu, and a word proceeding from him, Alqaha ila Maryama wa ruhum minhum, which he bestowed upon Mary, and a spirit proceeding from him. Fa'aminu billahi wa rusulihi, so believe in Allah and his messenger, Jesus. Did you tell them that? He says, no. The Egyptians are telling me no. I say, Allah tells you. He says, tell them. وَلَا تَكُولُوا ثَلَاثَا, don't say Trinity. إِنْتَهُ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ, this is, stop it, it'll be better for you. إِنَّمَا اللَّهُ إِلَهُ وَاحِدٌ, for your Allah is one Allah. He's not three in one. He's not one in three. I said, did you tell them that? He said, no. I said, Allah tells you in the Quran. لَكَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهُ هُوَ الْمَسِيحُ ابْنُ مَرْيَمُ. Anyone who says that Jesus Christ, the Son of Mary, is God, is making kufr. It's an act of blasphemy. It's treason against God. وَقَالَ الْمَسِيحُ, but Christ. وَقَالَ الْمَسِيحُ, but Christ said, Masih said, Ya Bani Israel, O children of Israel, لَعْبُدُ اللَّهِ, worship Allah, رَبِّي وَرَبُّكُمْ, who is my Lord and your Lord, إِنَّهُ مَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ, whoever will associate anyone with Allah, فَقَدْ حَرَّمَ اللَّهَ لِلْجَنَّةِ, Allah will make Jannat haram for them, وَمَأْوَاهُ النَّارِ, and the fire of hell will be their dwelling place, وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنصَارِ, and for the wrongdoers there will be no one to help. I said, did you tell them that? He says, no. Allah tells you, قُلْ, tell them, Ya Ahl al-Kitab, O people of the book, O Jews and Christians, تَعَالَوْ, come. إلى كلمة سواء بيننا وبينكم, that we come to common terms as between us and you. Let us get out to a common platform. أن لا نعبد إلا الله, that we worship none but Allah. ولا نشرك به شيئا, and that we associate no partners with him. ولا يتخذ بعضنا بعضا أربابا من دون الله, and that we do not take from among ourselves lords and patrons other than Allah. فإن تولوا, but if they turn back, فَقُلُوا شَهَدُوا بِأَنَّا مُسْلِمُونَ, tell them that we are Muslims, we have submitted our wills to the will of Allah. I said, did you tell them that? Did you call them ta'ala? I said, no. I want to know why. I said, you read this, you understand what you're reading, Allah is telling you, and you don't hearken. ثُمُّ بُكْمٌ أُمْنٌ فَهُمْ لَا يَرْجِعُونَ.